the culture and the religion are two different things. So I think in a strange way, Somalis deal with death better than the majority of people because we're Muslim. Because of that reason, we don't have a problem talking about death. But the issue is that support, is that when someone is dying, how do you deal with it? How do you get support emotionally? How does the person get taken care of? You know, because in Islam, we're preparing to die every day because nothing is guaranteed. You could die tomorrow. So we don't internalize it as, oh my goodness, I'm gonna die. No, you're gonna die. It's just you pray that you don't die a death that's hard. You pray that you don't die a death where you are cannot take care of yourself. And this is what most Muslims and Somalis fear, is that when they get older, that's their number one fear. It's a fear that they don't even want to talk about. How do you deal with somebody having to change your diapers, you know, we don't talk about these things. It's seriously, it's seen as shameful, like that we can't even say, I want to take care of my parents if anything happened to them. It's just amazing. Yeah. We don't talk about it. They know it's their responsibility to handle their affairs prior to death. So if, even in Islam, you're committing a sin if you're not doing that, because you are supposed to leave here without having had like caused transgressions to other people. You're accountable to your maker. So what's happening now is that when people are not dealing with their affairs, I think it has more to do with, it's the stress, right? It's the stress of the illness. They don't know what's coming next. And it's a big shame in my community that we're not talking about this, but I'm inspired now to actually do more about it.